The most expensive house in the world as of May 2021 is Buckingham Palace. Buckingham Palace is the most expensive and beautiful house in the world ever built, but it is not personal property. Its current value is around $5 billion, and it is situated in the center of the state occasions and royal hospitality place in the City of Westminster. Before 1730, the property was known as Buckingham House. After that, it was in private ownership for at least 150 years. Then, it was taken by King George III in 1761 as a private residence for Queen Charlotte and became known as the Queen's House. Right now, Buckingham Palace has served as the official London residence of the UK sovereigns since 1837. This house is designed by professional architects William Wynde, John Nash, Aston Webb, Thomas Cubitt, and Edward Blair. Hi viewers, welcome back to my new video. Did you know that every home is precious, but depending on the price and historical background, a home can be worth a price beyond our imagination? Today we will be talking about the most expensive house in the world. Let's start talking about the interior of Buckingham Palace. Of course, you don't expect the interior of the most expensive house in the world to be simple. It's going to be appealing and features expensive decor. In Buckingham Palace, every single floor is designed using top quality and expensive materials. The front of the palace measures 355 feet across by 390 feet deep by 80 feet high and contains over 830,000 square feet of floor space. There are 775 rooms, including 188 staff bedrooms, 92 offices, 78 bathrooms, 52 principal bedrooms, and 19 staterooms. It also has a post office, cinema, swimming pool, doctor's surgery, and jeweler's workshop. The principal rooms are contained on the piano nobile behind the west-facing garden facade at the rear of the palace. The center of this ornate suite of staterooms is the music room. Flanking the music room are the blue and the white drawing rooms. At the center of the suite, serving as a corridor to link the staterooms, is the picture gallery, which is top-lit and 55 yards long. The gallery is hung with numerous works, including some by Rembrandt, Van Dyck, Rubens, and Vermeer. Other rooms leading from the picture gallery are the throne room and the green drawing room. The green drawing room serves as a huge anteroom to the throne room and is part of the ceremonial route to the throne from the guard room at the top of the grand staircase. Inside the guard room are white marble statues of Queen Victoria and Prince Albert in Roman costume set in a tribune lined with tapestries. These very formal rooms are used only for ceremonial and official entertaining, but are open to the public every summer. Looking underneath the state apartments are the less grand semi-state apartments. Opening from the marble hall, these rooms are used for non-official entertainment, such as luncheon parties and private audiences. Some of the rooms are named and decorated for particular visitors, such as the 1844 room, decorated in that year for the state visit of Tsar Nicholas I of Russia, and the 1855 room, in honor of the visit of Emperor Napoleon III of France. At the center of this suite is the bow room, through which thousands of guests pass annually to the Queen's garden parties. This magnificent building also contains the yellow drawing room, which has wallpaper supplied in 1817 for the Brighton Saloon, and a chimneypiece, which is a European vision of how the Chinese chimneypiece may look like. When it's time for official visitation, foreign heads of state are usually entertained by the Queen at Buckingham Palace. They are allocated an extensive suite of rooms known as the Belgian Suite, situated at the foot of the Minister's Staircase on the ground floor of the north-facing garden wing. What's going on at Buckingham Palace today? Today, Buckingham Palace is very much a working building and the centerpiece of the UK's constitutional monarchy, serving as the venue for many royal events and ceremonies, from entertaining foreign heads of state to celebrating achievement at investitures and receptions. More than 50,000 people visit the palace annually as guests to state banquets, lunches, dinners, receptions, and garden parties. Receptions are held at the palace every year to recognize the work of industry, government, charities, sport, the Commonwealth, and other areas of life. For example, a couple of years back, the Queen hosted a reception to celebrate the Commonwealth, youth, and education, which was attended by 350 guests from academic institutions around the world and included a performance by the Commonwealth Youth Orchestra and Choir, and more recently, in 2015, Her Majesty hosted a reception for players, organizers, and supporters of the Rugby World Cup. The balcony of Buckingham Palace is one of the most famous in the world. The first recorded royal balcony appearance took place in 1851, when Queen Victoria stepped onto it during celebrations for the opening of the Great Exhibition. Since then, royal balcony appearances have marked many occasions, from the Queen's annual official birthday celebrations to watch the RAF fly past at the end of Trooping the Colour, royal weddings, as well as special events of national significance, such as the 75th anniversary of the Battle of Britain. Whilst Buckingham Palace is seen as the administrative hub of the monarchy, it is also very much a family home, in addition to holding the Queen's Gallery and the Royal Mews. The Queen gave birth to Prince Charles and Prince Andrew at the palace, and to this day, notice of royal births and deaths are still attached to the front railings for members of the public to read. The christenings of the Prince of Wales, Princess Royal, the Duke of York, and Prince William took place in the music room, and many royal weddings have been celebrated at Buckingham Palace. Most recently, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge's. The offices of those who support the day-to-day activities and duties of the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh and their immediate families are located at Buckingham Palace. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, comment down below your thoughts, give this a like, share with your friends, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to keep you updated for more information.